Everywhere Radio. His name is David Miles. What's New for Lunch? That's a track called Walk With Me. And Charlie Hickey before that, Planet With Water, bringing you two new tracks every day at this time on What's New for Lunch. Up next in the essential MVY slot where we love to go deeper and play deeper tracks from an artist. It's even better when we have an artist here to talk with us. Brooke Annabelle is next on MVY.
Loves Fun and Frolic USA, celebrating 30 years so far, inviting you to visit 4frolic.com for your juggling sticks and frisbee needs. That's the number 4frolic.com. Keep jamming. And also from sustaining donors like Susan in Palm Beach Garden, Florida, Barbara in Barnstable, Mary Beth in Plymouth, Stephen in Wellesley, Mass., Barry in Springfield, New Jersey, Todd in Bloomfield, Connecticut, and Shelley in Chicago.
Every Tuesday throughout the summer, we are at the Winnetou Oceanside Resort in Katama. Tuesdays at 6 o'clock in July and August for free shows as part of our Live from the Patio summer concert series. Brooke Annabelle is here up from Rhode Island today, and we'll be playing live at 6 o'clock. Brooke, welcome.
Thanks for having me.
Welcome back. Oh, wait, let's try this microphone. Are you there?
I'm here.
Oh, there you are. All right, there we go.
I have arrived.
We prepped for like a half an hour, and I still hit the wrong button. Well, welcome. Did you have a nice ride to the island this morning?
I did, yeah. Brought the chihuahua with me and just enjoyed the view. And, yeah, I'm in that island haze like we were talking about.
Do you feel like you're in dream vacation land now?
Yeah, at least for the next, couple hours.
All right, good. Well, the place we're sending you today, the Winnetou, I know you just got on the island, is this lovely hotel and space, and you're right near the beach, so you'll be able to take your new buddy for a walk on the beach.
Nice. So nice.
And enjoy a good afternoon. So you've got a new record coming out in the fall.
Yeah.
All right, called Better By Now. This will be like the first like full-length release in a couple of years?
Yeah.
Like pre-COVID?
Yeah. Last one was 2018, so I started recording this about a year ago, and here it is, finally coming all out.
That's good. So did, I guess that means like all of the writing sessions related were kind of like in the midst of whatever, quarantining, not quarantining, but, staying home and in kind of from that perspective, or at least informed by it?
Some of it, yeah. I mean, we had a lot of time to think, a lot of overload of information, so sometimes it was hard to be creative, but after a while, I found some spaces in my brain that had ideas to write about.
How do you for you personally, like what is your process, like when do you find yourself to be the most creative?
Good question. It's usually after I have created something. I create something and then I just feel the motivation to keep doing it, because it's so exciting when you sort of chase a song for a while, and then when you find something, you're like, oh, I want to keep doing that.
Yeah, and start the next thing or tap into whatever you tapped into. I think it'd be great if we just here early in the interview, just gave people a song, if you would play something for us.
For sure, yeah. I was going to play a song called What If You, which definitely sort of came from the perspective of can I get out in the world and do this again, make music, be vulnerable, do the whole thing, because I think a lot of us re-examined our lives during the last couple years, and so this is a little bit about that, but yeah.
All right, well, here's Brooke Annabelle. She's performing today, 6 o'clock at the Winnetou, a free show, and here she is on MVY Radio.
I should probably focus on figuring it all out. Lots of beat of miss, and all I can feel is that I'm
one of my favorite parts of like the interview process is trying to figure out when the artist is done, and I can always tell you smile. you're in the song, and then when
that's
you're done,
so interesting.
You smile, and then I know I'm okay to ask you a question. So we've been playing that song, like the album version of that song, for a couple of months now, and I was really excited to hear you play it because, you know, I was listening to it again this morning, like in headphones, and when you get to the chorus part, you kind of layer vocals on it. Now, you know, first, is that all you, or do you have another singer that matches you well?
It's all me.
It's all you.
Yeah.
And do you love playing? Do you like playing around in the studio with that kind of stuff?
I do. Yeah, I like singing harmonies
with yourself.
Yeah, it's fun. I'm with other people as well.
Sure.
It's just fun. I don't know.
It's fun to find that.
Yeah.
That spot where two things fit together.
Yeah. Most of the time I write my own, but then sometimes like whoever I'm working with will be like, try this thing, and I'll be like, oh, that's really hard. And then when we get it, it'll be it's like awesome, you know.
Yeah. Are you a creature of the studio? Like, is that a place where you feel comfortable, or do you have to go in with somebody else and you know, like, you need a guy?
Well, I am not technically as savvy enough to do all the things that I want to do all by myself, but mm-hmm. I do have like a home studio set up, and you know, record my demos and stuff there. But I actually really, really love being in the studio, and it's like, it's probably my favorite part of my job, because it's like when the songs come to life with other people, and you've just had them in your head for so long, and then all of a sudden they exist. They like actually exist, you know, they're born or whatever. It's the thing that I don't get to do the most often in my job, but it's probably my favorite part. So like, I really enjoyed making this record, and just, yeah.
Where did you make it?
So I started making this record remotely in early 2021. I did do some of the engineering on this record, because I recorded some vocals at home, some guitar at home, some little piano parts at home. But I ended up making the majority of the record out in Pasadena in California. Actually started it like a year ago today.
Oh, wow.
So, right. Yeah.
And what was that process like? Did you bring a band out with you?
So this was a really interesting, different process, because it was just me and the producer, whose name is Lizzie Langdon, and we just went back and forth for a while remotely, like sending it back and forth, playing different parts, and then when we were in person, it was just us two, and then there's a drummer that put, so it's just the three of us that played on the majority of the songs. So yeah, it was really, it felt like a very like safe step back into the world, you know?
Yeah. Do you, in the past, would you bring a band in? Like, is that like a play live?
Yeah, in the past, all of my other records, there's been like a live band component to it. So this was definitely different, but I loved it. It was so fun.
What's it like to have like a full record done and know that it's not out for two more months?
You know, it's been done for a little while, so it's hard to hold on. But I'm just excited. You know, I've shared three songs so far, so those songs are out in the world. Another one's coming in a couple weeks, and it'll kind of be here before I know it. You know, I'm just doing so much stuff to let people know about it and share the new songs. So, yeah, I'm excited.
I'll mention again, we're talking to Brooke Annabelle. She's performing today, 6 o'clock at the Winnetou Oceanside Resort for a free show. You're also, I should mention, that's our show, so I have to mention that, but I'll parenthetically say, you're also on Cape Cod this week.
Yeah.
Yeah, at the Music Room, opening for Will Daly.
Thursday.
So our Cape Cod listeners who can't get on a boat today, go Thursday to the Music Room.
For sure.
All right. Can you talk about the title of the record?
For sure, yeah. So the title of the record is Better By Now, and it's based on a song that I wrote in January of 2021, where it was sort of like, I think we all had 2021 in our minds as like a finish line or something, like, if we just get through 2020, everything's going to be better on the other side, right? And then we got there, and it was sort of like, okay, the pandemic's still bad, politics are still insane, it's... what's happening? I thought it would be better by now, you know? So it was kind of inspired by that, but also, like, I had I personally was going through like a mental health journey of like, I mean, we always are, but just sort of, oh man, I thought maybe I would feel better about things right now. And then through writing that song and recording that song and thinking about what is this song about, I sort of discovered, oh, I can't focus on these external outcomes to provide my own like betterness. Like I have to work on myself and feel better myself, and everything else can be chaos around me, but you know, as long as we're, I don't know, finding joy somewhere, you
yeah.
know. So this kind of, it really helped sum up the whole spectrum of emotions on the record.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just trying to get at how to be okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Were you going to play that one?
I can.
Well, no, what are you going to, I always ask this question, like, how many songs do you want to do? And I forgot to ask beforehand. So.
Yeah. I mean, I could do two, I could do three. We can sit here all afternoon.
You could just play to your heart's content as far as I'm concerned. But yeah, I mean, if you want to do that one and do one more after that,
sure.
I'd be thrilled.
Yeah. We'll go through the spectrum of emotions if I do this one now and then another one I have planned.
All right. That sounds great. I'll give you a second to tune up, and I'll say again, this show happening 6 o'clock today at the Winnetou Oceanside Resort. Three shows every Tuesday at 6 o'clock all the way through the end of August. These shows are made possible thanks to a generous contribution from Brenda and Leon Brathwaite and from Tajmu Insurance.
I'm all ready.
Oh, good. All right. Here's Brooke Annabelle on MBY Radio.
Facing
Brooke Annabelle. Better by now. She's playing today at the Winnetou. And we hope you go check it out as one of our free shows. Let's talk a little bit about, what do you do when the record's done?
When the record is finished being recorded?
Yeah.
Then you start planning how to get it out into the world, which I think maybe a lot of people don't think about how much stuff goes into that. So I started dreaming up ideas for the artwork, for music videos, which I made more music videos for this record than any other record before.
Do you, when you say you make them, like, are you the creator?
I am not the creator. I think of ideas and then I find someone who's good at that stuff.
Yeah.
So I put up a music video for every song that I put out so far, which is not in my comfort zone to be on camera.
I don't know, you took over our Instagram today.
I did.
Yeah.
Yes. That's a little
That's easier.
I mean, that's still hard actually, but it's easier.
Everybody gets to see your dog.
Yep.
If they go to our Instagram page.
Yep, he's on there.
What was your first post-COVID live show like?
My first post-COVID live show was outside in New Hampshire, and it was awesome. It was just, I feel like every time I've stepped on stage since, I've been, like, extra grateful. And just sort of, you know, just more at ease with the whole process. You know, everything can be stressful if you let it, and I'm very guilty of getting stressed out and anxious, but I mean, I was just on a tour for a couple of days. I was with my good friend Mark, and we were having like a crazy sound check, and I was like, I'm enjoying every minute of this.
Good. That's a great
because, like,
embrace it.
It's a story for years that we'll talk about, you know.
So. I sometimes like to ask artists, like, I want your worst gig, best gig story. You could pick either one.
Oh, man.
Like, what is, like, a worst, and it could have been fun, but worst, or best, like, oh my God, I can't believe I'm doing this.
And I have to answer this question right now.
You don't have to answer. No, there's no pressure to answer this question.
I'm like,
you can answer it on Instagram later.
Yeah, I will have to think about it.
Okay.
Because, like, some certain things pop into my mind where I'm like, oh, that was crazy. There was a jackhammer going off while I was playing outside in, like, but that wasn't the worst show, you know.
Right. Yeah.
And then you said, like, I can't believe I'm doing this. Like, one of my music video shoots was like that, because I was in the middle of, like, the desert in Joshua Tree, California. Cool. And there was a drone flying around me, and the sun was setting, and I was like, what is life? What is this?
Yeah.
You know? So those are my quick answers.
I love those answers. Can you, because we're a nonprofit radio station, can you talk a little bit about your interaction with independent radio? Like, is that a part of your world?
Yeah, I mean, independent radio is the radio that would play me. So
yeah.
I, you know, anytime I get a chance to stop in the station, it's really cool. So.
Yeah. I'm glad, you know, it's not easy. Not everybody wants to get on a ferry and come to.
Oh yeah.
Come here. So
it's been a couple years. You guys have great new digs here, and it's beautiful place to come. I'll come anytime.
Brooke is one of the folks who definitely saw our old place.
Yeah.
Our old sketchy cabin in the woods place. So you get to compare and contrast.
Yeah.
All right. Well, how about just one more?
Sure thing.
Okay. Yeah. What are you going to do?
So this is The Spectrum of Emotions. This song is about falling in love with my wife, who I got to marry last summer. Thanks. We had a postponed pandemic wedding, and it got to happen. And this song is sort of about, like, what I wanted that day to look and feel like, and also just a little bit about our story. So it's called 5 a.m. Some sweet story from my past.
Thank you so much. That sounded great.
Thanks so much for having me.
Absolutely. And you're going to hang with us for the day because you'll be at the Winnetou Oceanside Resort today, 6 o'clock, for a free show as part of MDY Radio's patio concert series. We hope you come to that. For listeners on Cape Cod, she's also performing with Will Daly at the Music Room Thursday evening. A Cape Cod trip. Thank you again so much, and we look forward to hearing more tonight.
Thanks so much.
All right. That's MDY Radio.